Hi everyone, so I'm just popping in here at the beginning of the video for how I did this page, and I just wanted to give you a heads up that I started the page using my Prismacolors, but shortly after I started the bird, I realized I did not care for my Prismacolors on this paper in these mythographic books. Honestly, I haven't done a whole lot of mythographic books. I just started getting into them. And the previous one that I did in here, the lion one, where is it? This one, I had a base of Neocolor II. So it was much more toothier, if that makes sense. There was more tooth for the pencil to stick to. I just felt like the Prismacolors just kind of laid on top with that wax. I couldn't get any depth to the colors. So what I did was I switched to my Polychromos after I worked kind of making a basic base layer with my Prismacolors on the bird. Then I switched to the rest of the page with my Polychromos, and I like those much better in this book. So I will be using Polychromos from now on in my mythographic books. So I just wanted to pop in here really quick to let you know before we get started with the video that you know, I had that little issue with the pencils. So the Polychromos set is the 120 set, I believe. Yes, 120 set that I pulled from. And I will put the colors on the screen so you know which colors I'm using. All right. All right, a couple things I wanted to add in addition to my editing insert there is that I also do use Tombow's the Tombow dual-tipped water-based markers as a base for the nest and for most of the flowers and all of the greenery around the nest. There within the nest, I should say. So I have listed all of the Tombows that I used down below, and also the number will appear on the screen as I'm using it. So let me know if you have any questions about anything, and I'll get right back to you. Right, so here I'm bringing out my Tombow mini eraser. I have to say, I absolutely love this little thing. But I'm just erasing off some areas along the edge of each of those feathers there where I can lay down some of that poppy red just to give a tinge of that orangish red color in the other part of the bird, so it kind of ties it in with those orangey red color feathers on his shoulders. All right, so for these two flowers, there's two of this type of flower that I'm coloring right here. And I did color them mostly with my Prismacolor pencils. And then I believe I went in and added some shading later on with the Polychromos. So once you have these two flowers colored in with the Prismas, you will see then I moved on to basing with some Tombow water-based markers. I just figured it would make the process much quicker and that the Polychromos would lay really nice over the top, and they did, and it ended up working out quite nicely. Right, so here is where I break out my Tombows, and I'm starting with 942, which is just kind of a medium light colored brown. And I'm just basing all of the twig areas with that Tombow, and the surrounding little ones that kind of are entwined around the nest there as well. And I just kind of fade it out as the ends of the branches turn into leaves. And then I'll come back in with some green Tombow and add some green in there as well. Okay, so just popping in here, I tried my best to decipher what was twigs. I'm gonna actually add a little bit in here. What was twigs and what was kind of background? You can see a lot of these gaps here that I left open. I went ahead and filled in most of the gaps close around to the center of the nest, and then filled or left open the ones that were kind of further out, like the nest is kind of loosening up as it goes out to the edge here. And then I carried the same brown into some of the twigs that were meandering out here. And then, so we're going to come in with, I have two different greens here, 131, 126, a light one, and kind of a medium light colored one. I want to stay pretty light because I'm going to go back in with my pencils for shading and, you know, textures. And we're going to do base these flowers because, yeah, basically I'm just using these Tombows as a base. And these flowers here are going to be based with the Tombow 761. I'll make sure that I put all the numbers on the screen for you. But yeah, so let's keep going. And I'll be popping back in, probably with voiceovers, maybe in video, explaining some more as we go along. Okay, so I have my base layer with the Tombows, the 761 light pink. And then what I've been doing, I did a lot of it off camera because I thought I was recording, but I wasn't. Is just going over some of these stems here where I had laid down some of the dark green 126. I'm going over it with the 131 just to kind of blend that in and give those stems a little bit of kind of a greenish brown color. Just the ones that are coming out here, the ones that are meandering out from the nest. I think I got most of them, but there's a few straggling bits here and there. And that's just gonna kind of tie in the green a little bit better. Start blending it in to the brown, kind of as a blend between the green and the brown. Hopefully that makes sense. So, okay, yeah. So go ahead and do that if you want. And here is where I am going to switch to my polychromos. I've pulled out a bunch of polychromos because, quite honestly, and I will list the colors down below, but also I'll put up on the screen which ones I'm using. To be honest with you, I was not really happy with how the Prismacolors were laying down on this paper. So I am fairly new to these Mythographic books. The only Mythographic page that I've done really is, well, I started that with markers, was that Lion and Luna Moth, this one. But I had based it with Neocolor II, and as far as the lion, and so that gave it a little bit more texture. And I found while I was coloring this bird and these two flowers, I felt like the pencil was just laying on top and I wasn't able to get that depth that I really like. So we're gonna come back in excuse me, and use these, use Prismacolors and see if I like those better. I think I will, because they're harder, you know, they're harder pencil lead, and I think they will lay down better on this really, really smooth paper. All right, so that's how we're gonna progress from here. All right, so let's go ahead and carry on with that. All right, so here I am starting with some of those twigs around the nest area there. And just with that walnut brown, putting in some shading where I think some twigs are overlapping or where one is going underneath, and leaving some open spaces because I'll be coming back in with a couple other colors. All right, so I'm getting ready to do the background with my Neocolor 2s, and I just want to tape off the edges. So I am using just some really low-tack washi tape and just doing my best to line it up just outside of that line frame that the artist had drawn in there. And that'll just keep my neo colors from going outside of that line. Then I'm getting my neo color 2s in sapphire blue, light blue, and salmon. And I am just scribbling some pigment down on my Caran D'ache textured palette. And I'm going to use the Neo 2s as like a watercolor to apply it to the paper. This paper, it's a lot different than other papers that I've used. It really soaks up that Neo Color 2. Luckily, these images are single-sided because I felt like I had to use quite a bit of water and ink to get a more opaque covering. So, I'm just kind of alternating. I put the darker blue, the sapphire blue, kind of in the corners and along the edges, and then using that light blue to blend that into the rest of the sky. And then I'll put in some spots of the salmon color just to add some variation to that background. Okay, so just finishing up the page here, I am going in with my Prisma colorless blender just to scratch off a little bit of the white Posca where I got it a little too thick in those hair highlights. And that's just a trick I like to use sometimes to tone down that white Posca in some areas. And so we are now finished with the page. I hope you've enjoyed it, and I will see you in the next video.